My name is Sam Miller. I am the author of Blackfish City, or La Cité de l'Orque, and it is a post-apocalyptic story of a woman who arrives in a floating city in a future where rising sea levels have changed the globe, and she shows up with a killer whale and a polar bear on a mission of bloody revenge. The characters in Blackfish City come from a wide variety of backgrounds. There is a young gay man, and there are two lesbian grandmothers, and there is a young person who is gender non-binary, and there's an asexual character, and one lonely straight person. So I wanted to have a bunch of characters that I don't often see in books, whose stories I know and who are stories that are important to me, but that I don't see a lot of on screens or in books. For me, I love cities, and I love living in one. I live in New York City. I love visiting. I've been to many cities around the world, and I always love, there's an excitement and an energy and a diversity, and there are many different types of people and many different types of food and activities. And so for me, I was trying to capture all the things that I love about cities, but also all the things that I hate about cities. And cities are places where we see humanity at its best, and most vibrant and creative, but also at its worst, and its most, you know, where you see things like inequality and suffering and poverty and homelessness at their most extreme, and racism and xenophobia. And so I wanted to talk about the things that I love and the things that I hate about cities. I have spent 15 years in New York City as a community organizer, working with homeless people and working on issues of housing and trying to ensure that there is housing for everyone. It is a reality in New York City, as in most big cities, that there are landlords who keep buildings empty. So you have homes without people and you have people without homes. And to me, that is a crime, and it is a problem that should be fixed. And so that is what I have spent many years working on in real life, and what I was trying to talk about in Blackfish City, because many times when we see a problem every day, we become blind to it, we become immune to it, or we think we can't do anything about it. But when we can think about it in science fiction lets us look at the same problems from a totally different lens and maybe think differently about it, and maybe feel like we can do something about it. So in my work as a community organizer, I have gone to many, many meetings with politicians. And I've gone to many mayors, city council members, senators, assemblymen to say, please do this thing. Please change this law. Please change this policy. And often I feel like I'm talking to a robot. Because the decision makers, they do not want to do anything. They do not want to make any change. And they want to say, oh, I can't do that. I don't have that power. Even if I think they do have the power, they just don't want to. So yes, this is very much, Blackfish City is my attempt to have a criticism of how politics works, and how if you don't have money, politicians are like robots. They don't want to listen. They don't want to do anything. And so the idea that that artificial intelligence makes all the decisions is a little bit satire, but also a little bit how I think that governments already work. For me, the thing that I am constantly exploring in all of my short stories and in all of my novels is that humans are terrible. And humans do terrible things. But humans are also wonderful, and they do wonderful things, and they make beautiful things, and they can come together to accomplish incredible things. And so I'd like to explore those two things, and with Blackfish City, I wanted to both show how the future can be very grim and can be full of horror and pain and war and suffering and devastation created by climate change and by our failure to do anything about it. But I also wanted to talk about the fact that we can change things. People can accomplish things. We need to start now, and we need to be doing more now. But at any point in the day, it is never too late. There will always be a way that human beings can fight to fix things and to make things better and to stop things from getting worse. So that is what many of my stories, and especially Blackfish City, what I'm trying to say is why I have hope, even if I also have great sadness and fear and pain.